The time has come to start the meeting of the consolidated financial results for fiscal 2015 for Hitachi Limited. First of all, I'd like to introduce the speakers for today. Mitsuaki Nishiyama, Senior Vice President, Executive Officer and CFO. Mitsuyoshi Toyoshima, General Manager of Finance and Accounting Department. Ken Mizoguchi, Executive General Manager of Corporate Brand Communications Division. I would like to ask Mr. Nishiyama to start the explanation. I would like to refer to the PowerPoint presentation entitled The Outline of Consolidated Financial Results for Fiscal 2015. Please refer to page 4. These are the highlights for the fiscal 2015 results. Revenues was 10,034.3 billion yen, which is up 3% year on year. It was higher in social infrastructure and industrial systems, information and telecommunication systems, and automotive system segments. Adjusted operating income was 634.8 billion yen, down 1%, or 6.4 billion yen decline year on year. And there was automotive system was strong, but profitability of construction machinery segment declined because of the slowdown. EBIT was 531.0 billion yen due to higher costs recorded for business structure reforms. Net income attributable to Hitachi Limited stockholders, 172.1 billion yen. This is down 45.3 billion yen year on year. The factors will be explained later. The total Hitachi Limited stockholders' equity ratio for manufacturing services and others was 25.6%. Free cash flow, 324.4 billion yen, which is up 187.1 billion yen from the previous year. The year-end dividend for fiscal year 2015 was 6 yen per share. Now, regarding the results of MHI announcement in May 9th for the South Africa project, the 379 billion request of payment was made by MHI. Now, to this point, we cannot accept this request. And in fact, this has been already referred to them on April 6th. However, we have set aside a certain reserve regarding this matter. Page 5 is the statement of profit or loss. At the very top, revenues was 10,034.3 billion yen, which is an increase of 259.3 billion yen. The 210 billion regarding weak yen impact is included, and if we exclude the reorganization, it will be around 100%. Or flat. And next is adjusted operating income, 634.8 billion yen. There was a demand decline in China as well as resource nations. And 15 billion was the impact of the foreign exchange. We have not been able to reflect this, and we have seen a deterioration. EBIT was 531 billion yen. Income tax changed significantly at 165.2 billion, which is increase in burden of tax by 43.1 billion yen. There are three factors relating to this. First of all, in 2014, the income increased for listed companies. Therefore, there was a posting of DTA, which went away in 2015. Now, secondly, because of the consolidated taxation group profit improved, therefore we have to start paying tax again. And Hitachi Capital reorganization, there have been some transfer of stake. And tax relating to DTA had to be posted in 2015 because of this reorganization. And the impact was 43 billion yen in terms of tax increase. this is having an impact on the bottom line as well. On the right-hand side, we have shown the previous forecast comparison. In terms of revenues, there is a difference of 84.3 billion yen positive. Adjusted operating income plus 4.8 billion. But in terms of income tax, there was a further increase by 38.2 billion yen, which is relating to Hitachi capital as well as Hitachi transportation systems reorganization required these costs to be posted. Another change is loss from discontinued operations to the tune of 57 billion yen. Out of the thermal power business, there were projects that were not transferred to the joint venture, which were dealt with by Hitachi Limited in terms of these projects. 39 billion has been posted. This is being subject to negotiation with various customers, therefore we cannot give you details. But this is cost relating to contractual terms, and that required additional reserves in 2015. And that means that compared to the previous forecast, there was a deterioration of 67.8 billion yen. Page 6 is the factors affecting changes in adjusted operating income year over year. Now, on the right-hand side, cost reduction, etc., 231.5 billion yen. And left-hand side, however, there was 120 billion in terms of lower sales price. Furthermore, investment in business development, 43 billion yen. An increase in labor costs and depreciation, 70 billion yen. This was covered by the cost reduction. However, as you can see toward the middle, there was a lower utilization, inventory optimization of 20 billion yen incurred. This is for construction machinery as well as materials and automotive system. Product demand declined and production had to be downsized. It has an impact in lower utilization. Inventory optimization took place, which amounted to 20 billion negative impact. Exchange gain is 15 billion. However, overall, because of the inventory optimization having a significant impact, it was minus 6.4 billion yen year over year. Next is for EBIT. As you can see in the middle, exchange loss impact is minus 9 billion. As I mentioned earlier, there's a 15 billion increase in terms of operating level, but 24 billion minus impact on non-operating basis was incurred. And also, the investment business development having a minus impact of 22 billion in terms of structural reform expenses. Investment in business in Hitachi construction material, 49.5 billion yen was a net gain on business reorganization and other expenses. And EBIT, however, deteriorated by 3 billion at 531 billion yen year over year. Page 10 is the revenues by market. Now, outside Japan ratio for 2014 was 47%. For 15, 48%. And year over year, 105% for outside Japan. We have seen decline in Asia, China, as well as other Asian countries. And China was 95% or and 99% for other Asia. But 88% for China, and for ASEAN, India, and others would be 89% if not for the impact of foreign exchange. Air conditioning business was restructured, which is having an impact. The construction machinery and others have seen a decline in demand in Asia, having an impact. On the other hand, for North America and Europe, there was an increase. For North America, Hitachi Metals, a Wabaka foundry, has been acquired. increase is seen. The unsaldo acquisition of railway business has led to an increase. Please refer to page 13. This is the balance sheet summary. The upper half is manufacturing services and others. The lower half is the financial services. For the total assets for manufacturing services and others was 9,970.9 billion, and you can see that there was an increase from the regarding CCC cash conversion cycle. It was 81.8 days at the end of 2015 March, and it has been reduced by 10 days to 71.6 days. Hitachi Limited stockholder equity ratio 25.6%. DE ratio was 0.4 times. The lower half is for financial services. Total assets is 3 trillion, above 3 trillion. Hitachi Capital Global Business has grown, which is included in this increase. DE ratio is 6.74 times. Next is page 14, cash flow. The middle is the manufacturing service and others. Cash flows from operating activities has improved to 843.1 billion because of the CCC improvement. As a result, free cash flow came in at 324.4 billion, increase over of 187.1 billion year over year. Please refer to page 16. 16 and 17. The segment information for 2015 in terms of revenue as well as profit. Looking at information and telecommunication system, product related business was slow, and deterioration have been overcome by system solutions, and as a result, increased by 6.1 billion. And profit margin was 6.7%, operating profit margin was 6.7%. And 7.9 for system solutions. Therefore, overall, is 6.7% is the best operating profit margin after Lehman Shock. Next is social infrastructure and industrial systems. Deterioration by 7.5 billion in terms of operating income. Overseas, in the Middle East, there are major projects, as well as Asian chemical plant are coming to a close. Projects have deteriorated. Oil and gas market deterioration has led to a decline in terms of compressors, sources, pumps, products has been negatively impacted. Projects have been negatively impacted, showing deterioration in number for EBIT. There was a decline of 81.2 billion yen year over year. For 2014, there was a profit from business reorganization, which is absent. Foreign exchange impact was 10 billion overall. That is the reason why we have a negative number for EBIT. For social infrastructure and industrial system, compared to previous forecast, it has deteriorated by 50 billion. Operating profit 8.6 billion. Deterioration has had an impact. This is relating to infrastructure. Middle East project has seen a cost increase. We had to set aside a reserve for this. In addition, EBIT basis, there is foreign exchange impact and structural reform, and fixed asset impairment is included. Construction machinery, the Kokusai Electric, and Hitachi Koki has had an impact of deterioration of 5.5 billion. And construction machinery has declined by 37 million because of a slowness in the Chinese market. High functional materials numbers are shown here. For automobile system, in the past 3 years, we have continued to increase our business, and 1 trillion has been achieved in terms of revenues. In addition, profitability has been improving as well. 2014 was 5.1% in terms of operating profit margin. It has improved to 6.2%. And next is smart life and eco-friendly system decline in revenues as well as EBIT because of air conditioning reorganization. If we exclude this, if we look at the white goods only, we have seen increase in revenues as well as earnings. Others, logistics and other services. No, Hitachi transport system is improved, increasing revenues as well as earnings. But EBIT has declined by 10.4 billion because of the land proceed gain has gone away. Financial service increased by 6.2 billion in terms of operating income. For corporate items and eliminations, EBIT was subject to significant change. This is because in the previous year, we posted major items, which is not included in this year. Next, page 19, please. Let me talk about fiscal year 2016 outlook. Starting with 19, this is the underlying premise of our forecast. Regarding the business environment, there is a continuing uncertain situation due to sluggish economic growth, mainly in China and natural resource and oil-producing countries. And the summary for fiscal year 2016 forecast, the conversion of Hitachi Transport System and Hitachi Capital Corporation to an equity method affiliate are factored in. The exchange rate assumption is 110 yen to the US dollar and 120 yen to the euro. Now let me explain the numbers on page 20. Revenues. 9 trillion yen. Adjusted operating income, 540 billion yen, 6%. And there's a yen strengthening impact and Hitachi Transport System and Hitachi Capital impact. And so the number will go down, but operating income ratio will be maintained at 6%. EBIT, 450 billion yen. And net income attributable to Hitachi Limited stockholders is 200 billion yen. Next, page 21, please. This is the increase and decrease of revenues and operating income centering on the business portfolio restructuring. Left side is revenues. Exchange loss of strong yen is minus 380 billion yen. Impact of reorganization of Hitachi Transport Systems is minus 490 billion yen. Hitachi Capital Corporation reorganization, minus 135 billion yen. And air conditioning business reorganization impact is minus 100 billion yen. So 9 trillion yen. Adjusted operating income on the right side. Exchange loss, negative 60 billion yen. Impact of reorganization of Hitachi Transport Systems, minus 28 billion yen. Hitachi Capital Corporation impact, minus 27 billion yen. And air conditioning business impact, minus 8 billion yen. 540 billion yen is the forecast. Now, Hitachi Transport Systems, the sale of some of our shares will be in the first quarter. Hitachi Capital in the second quarter. This is when we expect to complete the deal. Next is page 22 and 23. Let me talk about forecast by segment. Information and telecommunication systems will be down by 3% in revenues, but operating income will be 143 billion yen, up 1.6 billion yen. On the other hand, EBIT will be minus 25.1 billion yen year on year. The server and storage, the product type business will have the business restructuring expenses. Next, social infrastructure and industrial systems. Large loss in the previous year, large costs in the previous year will be no longer be
there, and so we will see an improvement. Electronic systems and equipment, Hitachi High Technologies, development cost will increase, and Hitachi Kokusai Electric semiconductor equipment will go down, so it will be down by 2 billion yen. Construction machinery sales will go down by 5%, but with the impact, positive impact of the business restructuring in 2015 and improvement of product mix will push up the operating income by 11.3 billion yen. High functional materials and components will be improvement of 6 billion. But EBIT, Hitachi Metals sold the shares, and the impact will no longer be there on 2015, so minus 29 billion. Next, automotive systems. Operating income down by 1.9 billion. This is ADAS, autonomous driving development costs will go up. Smart life and eco-friendly systems. This is the impact of the reorganization of air conditioning business, so down in operating income. Others, Hitachi Transport System is included, but this will be gone from the first quarter, and so the revenue will be 51%, and operating income will go down too. Financial services, 36%, and down by 30.2 billion yen. This is Hitachi Capital reorganization impact. Now, others segment. This had transport systems and services and others, logistics services and others, but we have changed the name to others because of the reorganization. Last, page 25 and onward, let me talk about the summary of midterm management plan. Page 25, it shows some numbers. It shows adjusted operating income ratio. Fiscal year 2012, operating income ratio was 4.7%. Fiscal year 2015 is 6.3%. Our initial target for fiscal year 2015 was over 7%. We could not achieve that, but we were able to secure over 6% ratio. We saw a big improvement in system solutions business in information and telecommunication systems. That was 6.7%, and automotive systems, 6.2%. So these segments, businesses, were the driver of the improvement in the operating income ratio. Second from the bottom, cash flows from operating activities. Fiscal year 2012 was 503.4 billion. Fiscal year 2015 was 843.1 billion. And it's not listed here, but cash flow margin ratio, 2012 was 5.7%. Fiscal year 2015 was 8.6%. So we realized an achievement. This is the record high level, so we now have more cash generating capability. Next, page 26, please. On the other hand, there are some challenges. At the bottom, you can see challenges. Number one. One is speedy response to changes in the market. We could not be speedy enough. IT-related projects, management, IT product type business. We had some delays in keeping up with the market environment changes. We are trying to reorganize our business to speed up. So we need to accelerate our management further. Under the new organization, we will accelerate the decision-making. Other is the thorough project management. In IT-type business, in information and telecommunications business, we had some unprofitable projects, but we no longer have that. We now have good phase gate management and project management. On the other hand, in infrastructure, the Middle East construction projects and others, there are some unprofitable projects, and so we lacked in project management capability there. However, we are going to focus on our strong points, so we will focus on our areas that we are strong. Next is accelerating business portfolio reform. Social innovation will be the center of the management resource, and so we will reform our business portfolio. Next, page 27, please. Initiatives for the next stage of growth. One is business restructuring. We will continue the business restructuring activities, mainly around the low-profit businesses. In fiscal year 2015, structural reform expenses was 90 billion yen, and the benefit was 20 billion yen. In fiscal year 2016, we will continue this business restructuring, especially around the low-profit projects. We will go ahead with reforming the problems areas. Structural reform expenses will be 80 billion yen. And benefit for through the measures in 2015 and 16 will be 55 billion yen. So in 2016, the benefit will be 35 billion yen. We will try to enjoy the benefit as well. Second is accelerating business portfolio reform. Hitachi Transport System and Hitachi Capital, which we announced today, they will be equity method affiliates. So we will be active in reforming our business portfolio going forward. Now, number one and two, if we conduct these measures, our revenue will temporarily go down. But we will not be afraid of the revenue decline. We will expand the social innovation business to grow organically and through M&A. We will focus our investment in this area to grow steadily. Fiscal year 2016, we will first do the review, reform of the business portfolio, so the top line will go down by 10%, but we will do what we must do. And on the other hand, we will expand and take measures to expand the social innovation business. Growth area strategy will be explained on the 18th of May from President Higashihara. That's all. Thank you very much.
We would like to move on to Q&A session. The microphone will be brought to you. Please wait for the microphone to be brought to you. Question. I have two questions. First question is regarding fiscal year 2016. You talked about the price decline as well as other cost factors were explained. So for this fiscal year, I would like to know what your assumptions are. Answer. Regarding the increase and decreases, it is basically regarding reorganization. From 2015 to 2016, in terms of offering profit, the most significant factor will be business structure reform impact, the increment, or 35 billion. That is a major factor. There are others. Price decline as well as cost reduction will be offsetting each other. Therefore, in terms of the total, the business structure reform is the most significant factor that will influence this. Now, regarding personal costs as well as the depreciation, and I think 113 billion was mentioned for the last term. What is the number for this term? Now, for 2016, how we should evaluate is that price decline minus 100 billion plus is what we have assumed. In terms of personal costs as well as depreciation, 30 billion, especially in terms of depreciation, is going to be very significant this term. Now, in terms of the business structure reform, the increase in 35 billion and 170 billion for personal costs, in terms of development related. At the time of April, Lumada was announced, and that's an increase of 40 billion compared to the previous year. It's a minus alpha impact, which will occur anew. I hope that will suffice. Now, regarding the second point, question. In page 16, you have talked about the social infrastructure industrial system. EBIT has declined in terms of compared to the previous forecast by 52.8 billion yen. In the beginning, you explained the increase in reserves for South Africa. Is that included in this number? Regarding South Africa, when you have accounting process, are you setting aside for your equity stake of 35%? Is that the case? Answer. Regarding South Africa, I'm sorry, but the details numbers cannot be disclosed. Regarding the accounting process, as well as how it is going to be posted, it cannot be divulged in terms of details. However, I can say that a reasonable number has been set aside as a reserve. But the details of the accounting procedure cannot be explained at this point in time. Question. On the part of the media, you said the 100 billion was mentioned by the media. So regarding this 100 billion, can you say that it is correct, or is it out of scope? Because this has been mentioned everywhere in the media, so please comment regarding 100 billion. Answer. In terms of the actual amount, basically, we cannot disclose information. How they are handled is not explained in details, not by MHI or not by Hitachi. And I do understand that 100 billion has been mentioned elsewhere, but we are not in a position to comment on this number. Regarding the reserve that we have set aside, cannot be disclosed in terms of the actual number.
Any other questions? Question. I have three questions. First, this year's business restructuring cost goes up by 35 billion yen. If you could elaborate or give us a breakdown on that. Last year was 20 billion yen. This year is 50 billion increase in profit. So the cost will not be that much bigger, but the benefit will be so much bigger. So which segment, which division will be more prominent? So please give us the breakdown. That's my first question. Second, maybe I'm misunderstanding this, but on page 21 and 23, the drop in sales and profit due to the non-consolidation, taking out of consolidation, their numbers are different. And so why is the result in the forecast different? Which page was that again? Page 21. 490 billion down in revenues from the Hitachi transport system. And page 23, others, revenue will go down by 600 billion or so. Why is the number so different? And same for the financial services. The numbers are different, and so I would like to know why. And my last question is cash flow. You said you are having cash flow, good amount of cash flow. In the new fiscal year, cash flow margin or free cash flow amount, what is your forecast? What is your plan, please? That's all. Answer. First, the business restructuring expenses, the breakdown. First, fiscal year 2015, the headcount adjustment was 450 billion of the 45 billion of the 90 billion. And then depreciation, total 90 billion. And 2016 is 80 billion. The headcount adjustment is 30 billion. And the impairment of fixed asset, 50 billion. In terms of headcount adjustment in 2015, 4,300 people are in the scope. In 2016, will be around 3,000 people. So the positive impact on operating income is bigger this year than last year. So 30 billion is going to go up to 50 billion yen. In fiscal year 2015, impact is 20 billion yen. But this is mainly in the second half. So in fiscal year 2016, it will be a full year contribution. So that is around 45 billion yen. And in fiscal year 2016, we are going to do the restructuring of 80 billion yen. So 10 billion is incorporated. So total 55 billion yen. Now, to answer your second question, the differences in the numbers is in revenues. It may sound strange to you. In waterfall chart, this is after the intercompany elimination. So after the elimination, it's the decline in revenue after intercompany elimination. And therefore, Hitachi Transport System is 490 billion yen. But in others, it's 600 billion yen minus. Now, the difference between 450 and 600 billion, about 110 billion yen, is the intercompany elimination. And same holds true for Hitachi Capital. Now, let me answer your third question, cash flow forecast. 2015, CCC is 71 days. It's a big improvement. But we will go back once, slightly. We have more capability, but IEP, the Europe Railway Project, sales will be in 2017 or 2018. It's a large-scale project. And so the inventory will accumulate. And therefore, we will have a slight decline here. Of course, we will continue improving CCC, continue taking measures to improve CCC. So free cash flow total will be around 100 billion yen. We will do investment, and there will be some increase in the working capital. But we would like to secure around 100 billion yen. Thank you very much.
Question. I have two questions. First question is regarding the impact of business structure reforms. The total amount is 35 billion. Can you give us a breakdown of segments? What is the breakdown by segment? Second is a regular question regarding the corporate agency elimination. It says minus 36 billion, but plus 13 billion in terms of actuals. What is your view on this? Please elaborate. Now, I would like to address the second question first. Regarding corporate items and eliminations, and for 2016, the business environment continued to be opaque. And out of the 36 billion, we have looked at 40 billion in terms of risk. And there are various structural reforms as well as reorganizations which will incur expenses. And therefore, non-operating basis, 20 billion risk is factored in. A total EBIT basis, is 60 billion risk that is being factored in for corporate items and eliminations. Now, regarding the impact of restructuring reform, regarding the absolute amount of 55 billion, is one third each. Information and telecommunication, information and telecommunication systems will account for half of the impact. The remaining half, 25% each, is regarding infrastructure for social infrastructure industrial system, and 25% for construction machinery, as well as metals, listed companies. Question. Regarding the increase in profit for information telecommunication system, is it can it be explained in its totality by the business structure reforms? I'm talking about the information telecommunication system increase in profit. Well, this term can be explained. It's only 1.6 billion, but the whole thing is business restructuring impact. Is that the case? Answer. There was increase in profit, which will go down. For example, a system solutions is a good case in point. Compared to products, profit margins are high, but system solutions revenue will be declining. For example, 2014, 2015, there was a significant demand for the My Number system, social security and tax number system projects were quite prevalent. Gross margins were very high for these projects, and this will go away. There will be an absence of this. Therefore, decrease in revenue will lead to decrease in earnings. But overall, business structure reforms will be an area where we can harvest gains. With this, we'd like to offset the decline in profit, so that we can increase both revenues and earnings.
Any other questions, please? Question. Regarding the South Africa project, you mentioned that you cannot talk about details, and I understand that. But in the press release, you said that you do not need to pay. That's what you mentioned. But even then, you are provisioning a certain amount. So I would like to know the reason. And in your this year's guidance, have you included this provision? Answer. Regarding South Africa, we have been negotiating with them for a while. And we said that we cannot meet their request. And so this negotiation is still underway. However, in the end, there may be some part, amount, that we have to bear. And so we anticipate a certain amount and provided, provisioned for that. Now, the forecast for 2016, we have not included this in fiscal year 2016 because by the end of 2015, we have already provisioned the reserve based on our assumption. And so it is not included in 2016 forecast. Question. This reserved amount, do you have an option to resolve this part first, or is the minimum requirement to resolve the entire negotiation? Answer. I'm sorry I cannot talk about the detail. There are 12 units in this project. It's a large-scale project. And it's about the project profitability of this large project. So total resolution or partial resolution cannot be achieved easily, so we would like to sincerely continue with this negotiation. Question. I'm sorry to be repetitive, but the project final timing, when do you think the project will be completed? And it's a little over 300 billion yen. You said that this is a minimum line. In other words, it may be bigger depending on the construction time period. So if you could give us your forecast. Answer. The completion period will be 3 to 4 years. So the same process as what MHI had said. So we share this process. Now, the amount that they've requested, it's minimum, but we think the reduction of the amount will be beneficial for both parties because it's our common profit. And so with MHPS, we'll manage the project solidly, which they are. And so we do not think that this amount will increase significantly. MHPS President Nishizawa is the professional project manager. And so, and he is doing a great job. So I trust him. On the other hand, South African labor environment is volatile, unstable. And that is why the period has been extended to this much. And so I do not anticipate this to go up that significantly. MHI, regarding MHI, there's nothing we can say in specific terms. What we can say is we will have the approval of the audit firms, and we are doing the accounting treatment thoroughly. And this is different from the negotiation. And so we cannot make any comments on where Mitsubishi Heavy Industry is saying at the minimum amount or what other comments they're making, because it's a different story.
Question. Basically, I have three questions, both complex and easy. As already mentioned today, for each of the main businesses, I would like to know what is the assumption for business environment for the fiscal year. For example, in IT, the orders received trend, as well as Sun NAS storage in the United States. How is it proceeding? Regarding the information telecommunication systems, how are you looking at the outlook in terms of hardware and software? For social infrastructure industrial systems in the Middle East, there were major projects last year. About overall, what is the assumption for the business environment? In terms of social infrastructure industrial systems, the elevator and escalators in China, it seems that for others, there are some improvements. But what is your outlook? Now, regarding automotive systems, in terms of business environment, what is your assessment? For smart life and eco-friendly systems as well. In terms of business environment, when you formulated these numbers, in April of next year, the consumption tax is likely to increase. How is that factored in terms of these numbers for the major businesses? So please elaborate further in terms of the business environment you are assuming for these numbers. Regarding business environment for information telecommunication systems, in the area of system solutions and platforms and products, we should separate for assessment. For 2014 and 2015, it was such that we had good demand in terms of the My Number system, because of, as well as the financial systems, there was strong performance because of the social security and tax number system. But this will only continue up until 2016. But there will be a decline in terms of the My Number system, as we have seen in 2015. But there should be some increase in fintech as well as security systems supporting fintech growing as well. We believe that there will be more projects in this area. Therefore, in the domestic market, system solutions look very strong. On the other hand, for products-related business, I believe that the environment will be more difficult. Servers is a good case in point. And large projects. Market is undergoing change. So I believe that the business is going to be very difficult, which means that another round of business restructuring will be required, which has been started in 2015. Now, regarding the social infrastructure industrial systems for China, elevators, for 2015, in the beginning, we had a significant backlog. Therefore, it was not impacted. Market was already declining, but our numbers were not impacted because we had a backlog in 2015. However, it is likely to decline in 2016 because of the absence of the backlog. In terms of the automotive systems, on the other hand, in the overseas market, profitability is improving now. However, in 2016, development expenses for driverless cars, there will be a negative impact on income. But we believe that the market is likely to be the same as 2015. In other words, we believe that the market will be strong in 2016 as well. In Kumamoto, the earthquake has hit. And the impact is not zero, but throughout the fiscal year, impact will be minimal, according to our assessment. What about the white goods as well as impact of possible consumption tax? Have you factored these in? Answer. Regarding the impact of consumption tax, has been factored in. But in terms of white goods, we believe that with the consumption tax, we can have an increase in revenues as well as earnings. Question, whether it be automobiles or industry products, there is a surge in demand before the consumption tax. So for automotive systems, last-minute surge before the hike is factored in? Answer. Regarding the automobile systems, we are not so cognizant, we are not so conscious about that. Second question. Now, in terms of increase-decrease analysis, the electricity charge as well as material cost, how is that factored in? Because I'm sure there is a decline. And last year, the power companies had a significant profit. Therefore, it is likely to have an impact on first half. In terms of material cost, this is also declining. How is this factored in? This is my second question. In terms of material cost, answer. For materials overall, the actual number for 2015 is an impact of 10 billion. For 2016, the price decline impact, the cost reduction impact is about 20 billion for materials for 2016. Crude oil related, on the other hand, with $1 change in the barrel cost, the impact will be 800 million domestically per year. So it is difficult to quantify. Currently, 5 billion is the impact of crude oil, according to our assumption. What about the utility charge? That is what I mean, utility charge. And we are also using some crude oil. That is also included in this number. Question. I would like to confirm the balance sheet for this fiscal year. Manufacturing and services are separated, but the capital will go away. So that means that manufacturing services will be the only component we'll be looking at that. And then we have to subtract the Hitachi transport system. This is the correct understanding. But the Hitachi transportation systems, when it becomes an equity method affiliate, what is going to be the impact on the balance sheet?
Answer.
No, the offset relationship is very complex, so it's very difficult to answer your question. But what we can say is that for manufacturing and services, the Hitachi transportation systems was in a better position. It's about 700 or so in terms of sales, and the asset size is around 500 billion, so it is more favorable. So in terms of asset turnover, it's about 0.99. Because of CCC has improved, it's about 1x. .93 or .94 is likely to be the number going forward. So 9 trillion revenue. And that means that a little bit less than 10 trillion in, because of the Hitachi capital and Hitachi transportation systems going away, that means that we'll have 10 trillion in terms of assets with 9 trillion sales, which means it's about 25 or 26% in terms of equity ratio, and the ratio, and we are assuming 30% going forward.
So one last question, please. Question. I have two questions. First is regarding Hitachi Capital that you announced today. So Hitachi Capital, you're doing this for positive purposes, but you will still hold 33% of their shares. What is the significance of owning 33%? MUFG Group, if it's a collaboration with MUFG, then you may not need to have 33%, I think. So why 33%? If you could give us the reasons, please. Why not 20% or 10%? Answer. Hitachi Capital is for our social innovation business. It plays a very important role. For social infrastructure business, the financial function cannot be sufficiently played only with Hitachi Capital. And therefore, we would like to reinforce this and utilize this more. So you said that maybe the shareholding can be even lower, but our operating companies, this is the common financial platform that we would like to utilize as the group. And so we want to secure the governance on this company. And therefore, we will send directors and do this solidly. And that is why we are still the largest shareholder. So 33.4% will be maintained. That is why we led to this decision. Question. In mass media, President Higashihara said that he will consolidate the business that is less than 5%. But this may not be a good example for the group. You will do more business restructuring this year. When will you continue? Until when will you continue this reform? So your understanding on the low profitability and your forecast, please, regarding this 5%. Answer. So 5% is the one of the guideline which we talk about internally. In fiscal year 2017 and onward, the ones that are less than 5% will be reviewed. But the BU, not just single BU or by segment, we will look in more detail by business and make decisions appropriately. That's what President Higashihara meant. So we will, in brackets, we will see the low profitability businesses and the ones that have low future, not viable. We may collaborate with other companies or wind down or exit or turn around. So we will decide on what measures to take. So our direction is to do as much as possible by the end of fiscal year 2016. But there are some businesses that will become obsolete with over time. So maybe things are okay now, but maybe risky in the future or already becoming outdated or the market is changing. So for those businesses, we will continuously do this. This activity is endless. Despite the economic fluctuations, this is something we need to do no matter what.
With this, we would like to bring this meeting to a close. Thank you very much for your participation.